Lord God, you know the desire of our hearts is to follow you where you lead us. The longing in each of us is to know you, to hear your voice, to encounter you in a meaningful way. Thank you, Lord, that you are here tonight. Amen. You know, the deep longing we feel to encounter God is actually the beginning of the encounter itself. For only God can place that longing into our hearts. We don't have to strain our ears to hear him. He's always speaking to us. For instance, have you ever been reading the Bible when suddenly you were gripped with a fresh new understanding? That was God speaking to you. When this happens, write it down. Meditate on it. Immerse yourself in it. Ask God to show you what adjustments you need to make to bring your life in line with him. Then make those adjustments. Watch to see how God uses it. God also speaks to us through his body, the church. The members of Christ's body guide his church in the same way that the members of the human body guide the Bible. For example, suppose you were walking down a train track when suddenly your ears informed you that a train whistle was blowing somewhere very near. Then your feet warned you of the rumbling motion of an approaching train. Wouldn't you get off those tracks as soon as possible? Well, we the church can learn to trust each other in exactly the same way. The most important way we hear from God is when we enter his presence to pray. There is no substitute for prayer. There's no way to be in God's presence and remain unchanged. Prayer is a two-way communication with God in which listening is more important than talking. As we pray, the Holy Spirit leads us into all truth. But truth is not just a concept. Truth is a person. To pray is to know Jesus Christ, who is